how many rooms are there in this building? There are 20 per floor, so times 5 including the basement. 20 times 5, 100 rooms. So per one room, imagine how many beds in one room? About 10 beds. Or about 10, because there are space for other things, not just beds. Or 10 beds, so very good estimate is 10 times 100, that is 1,000. So this big TCU size building can be done in 1 week. And even if we love at Chinese made products, if you search the super engineered technology in China, you will be amazed. You will be amazed. Nowadays, previously, they are lovable, but there are so much time for their what? Trial and error. Now they are reaping the dividends of trial and error. After some time, they are trying, and there are many errors, there are many mistakes, but now they are learning so much for that mistake, and now perfecting every technology there is. Okay? So, for the next paragraph in history is the plumbing trade was duly recognized by the government 1902. So 16th century start of plumbing, but license 1902 compared to civil engineering, which license about 1950s. So civil engineering and architecture is about the same 1950s. Compared to 1902, recognized by the government, the city of Manila was the model community. The first master plumber is recognized. Okay, and the plumbing code of the United States was incorporated into the building code of the Philippines. Okay, so in 1935, the National Master Plumbers Association of the Philippines. Well, what is that? National Master Plumbers Association. National Master Plumbers Association of the Philippines. Right? National Master Plumbers Association of the Philippines. Right? Was started 1935. So that's why civil engineering PICE was changed from 1955 to 1935. Civil engineers cheat their history in order to be called the first professional organization. Hello, Kati. So, they do not want to be called number two. Civil engineers want to be called number one. So, they adjusted. That's why it is written on the PICE logo. 1935. Okay? That is the usual attitude of civil engineers. So, okay? So, the national government through the Bureau of Public Works, so that is the old name of DPWH, Bureau of Public Works, adopted the Plumbing Code of Manila, and this is how it is became the reference code of National Building Code. So I already discussed this, that the National Building Code of the Philippines composed of so many reference codes like Plumbing Code of the Philippines. Okay. So in 1954, again, there is a bill, and after third reading, this became the Plumbing Law of the Philippines. So, Plumbing Law of the Philippines, what? professionalizing and what? So it is what earlier than both architect and civil engineers, no? 1954, signed by President Ramon Magsaysay. So on 1959, the plumbing, National Plumbing Code of the Philippines was prepared and became a law. Then 1967, the first amendment to the plumbing code. This is what we are talking about. This is the plumbing code of the Philippines. First amendment is approved, which affected the inclusion of asbestos cement pipe as an approved material. Take note, asbestos material is now obsolete because of health issues. But 1967, it is included as a material of quality. Okay? Before martial law, 1972, Republic Act 6541, otherwise known as the Building Code of the Philippines. Okay. It is replaced by another Republic Act, so National Building Code of the Philippines. Then 1959, this code was being referenced by National Building Code of the Philippines. So in 1996, NAMPAP spearheaded the revised National Building Code. So you will notice, if you read the title, it is not National Plumbing Code of the Philippines, but revised. It is already revised, okay? So where is the revision? The revision was made when? The revision was made starting 1996 and was approved and adopted 1999. So this law, this code, is 1999. So NPCP, National Plumbing Code of the Philippines, does 99, so meaning 1999. So this is 1999, and that is by President Joseph Estrada, RA 1378. So plumbing law,
RA 1378. This is plumbing law.
Under plumbing law, you will read the qualification, how to be a licensed master plumber, okay? So registered master plumber, okay? So this book is about the necessities of life, such as the use of air, water, and food. So if we use air, water, and food, there should be a plumbing system. Okay, so air coming in should be discharged, particularly those harmful air. What is harmful air? We already inhale the air, and then most of the percentage is carbon dioxide. Not all is carbon dioxide, but most of the percentage is carbon dioxide. That must be discharged. That's why we have to circulate the air. For example, using air conditioning, so the air is just coming in at the top, and the air is going out the bottom part. That is square, the bottom part. That is the air outlet. The used air, the inhaled air, that is full of carbon dioxide, is now going outside through that vents, lower portion, that square. Okay? So the same is true with air when we use what? Plumbing system. For example, the toilets, the comfort rooms are under the authority of master plumber. And the air inside the CR toilet are not good for our health. So that must be discharged, even the air, okay? So again, for food and water, those are the root cause of our
urine and human waste. So those are all have to be discharged properly.